over 25 years, the sounds of guns and mortars echo through the lives of these people. Most of them were terrorized. Most of them lived in fear, thinking, when will it end? Will we see an end of this brutality? Or will the brutality end us? A question that kept them awake many, many nights. Running from one place to another just to hang on to dear life. It was indeed a battle. A battle between two sides. A battle between life and death. A battle between rights. A battle between hearts and minds. And then one day, it ended. The war is over. 25 years of brutality paid its final debt. Once again, hope was born. Once again, a life of happiness seems to be a possibility. And once again, life in its entirety had a chance. This is not a story or a reminiscence of a land once was. On the contrary, this is the story of Ramayya, the ice cream maker, and Arunachalam, the potter of Kilinochi. Welcome to Kilinochi. From this setting come some of the most beautiful scenery, some of the exotic wildlife, and some of the worst atrocities mankind has ever known. But not all hope is lost. Most of the people in Kilinochi are now determined to erase that past and fill it with new memories and achievements in making their home once again known for its rich heritage in ancient Sri Lanka. Kilinochi, located 345 kilometers north of the capital of Sri Lanka, Colombo, was established in 1936 as part of the colonization project that sought to ease overpopulation and unemployment in Jaffna, also known as the northern capital of Sri Lanka. Kilinochi fell into the control of the Liberation of Tamil Tiger Elam, or the LTTE, in 1990 and became the de facto capital of the rebel army. This was reclaimed by the Sri Lankan military in 2009 with the fall of the LTTE. Most people living in Kilinochi are Sri Lankan Tamils. Kilinochi is one of the main agrarian cultivation destinations in the island from prehistoric times. With the war coming to an end in mid-2009, life in Kilinochi has begun to rise from the ruins of devastation. People have returned to their homes. Even though all that once was has gone forever, they are happy to be in a place they can call home. Everyone is pitching in to do whatever they can in order to help out this devastated community. Little girls and boys wake up every day not to run away from harm's way, but to go to school and study, eventually to improve the community that they live in. Just few meters away from the famous A9 road in a village called Vivekanandanagar, you meet Arunachalam. Arunachalam is 51 years old. He is a potter in profession. Today he is spinning a pottery wheel, or more like his version of the pottery wheel, to make some pots from the clay that he bought from a nearby village after walking over 10 miles. By the day's end, he intends to finish at least closer to 50 pots so that his wife can sell it at the village market. While spinning the wheel and making his pots, the grim situation that he experienced through comes to his mind.
යුද්ධ කාලෙත් මේ තමයි හිටියේ. ඉట్లా යුද්ධ කාලේ එන්නේ නැහැ මහට ගියා අපි මිලිවා කියලා දිහට. මාතලම් මේ පැත්තේ ගිහිල්ලා එහෙම මමදාවත් එක්ක වුණියා ගියා.
ආ එතකොට මේ ගෙවල් එහෙම මොනවද?
ගෙවල් ඔක්කොම ඉතින් එහෙම දාලා ගියා ඉතින්.
Arunachalam is the father of four. He has three sons and a daughter. However, today he's just a father to two of them. A bitter past keeps him awake at nights. In 2006, Arunachalam and his family lost their elder son while trying to take cover from a rain of bullets during the conflict. Since that time, he has done his utmost to find his son, but to no avail. Now Arunachalam and his family want to look ahead and work for the future. Building a new life has become priority for all in his family. Currently, he lives in a small shed covered with aluminium sheets, which is right behind his pottery wheel, where all his family squeeze in at night for a cramped sleep. Trying to build a new house has become priority number one for Arunachalam. He is now one of the recipients of the Sri Lanka Red Cross post-conflict recovery program, which looks at aiding the most vulnerable people in the north.
Over 20 years of a trauma people have gone through with the war, and ultimately for some time they had to stay in camps, and when they return it's not easy for them to build up their own lives just on their own. So Sri Lanka Red Cross have felt that it is a big effort those people to build their houses, rebuild their lives, find livelihood. Things are of course generally okay, but that doesn't mean people cannot forget what they went through for 20 years. Shelling over their heads, some of their family members killed, dragged away by force, and that all comes to their mind. You will see them smiling and laughing when we go, but that really is not the case. It's not easy for them. So we have felt to be beside them. We feel that we have to be beside them. Today, therefore, we have gone in assisting them.
During the 2008-2009 phase of the conflict, the Sri Lanka Red Cross, in cooperation with International Committee of the Red Cross, provided services to the affected people from within the territory controlled by the LTTE. The SLRCS, Jaffna, Waunia, Mena, Trincomalee, Batticlo, Ampara, Anuradhapura and Polonnaruwa branches, with support of several partner national societies and the International Federation of the Red Cross, responded in a coordinated manner as the crisis evolved. During the first quarter of 2010, with a gradual relaxing of access restrictions to the northern region, the Sri Lanka Red Cross and the Red Cross Movement partners developed an integrated program to support the return and recovery of the IDPs. The program is primarily in support of people who have been displaced due to the conflict and are either still displaced or in the process of resettlement. Similar to the Post-Tsunami Community Recovery and Reconstruction Partnership, the so-called Red Cross Post-Conflict Recovery and Reconstruction Program supports the people's process of reconstructing their homes by providing cash grants, grants for reconstruction of community infrastructure, technical support and community mobilization in the areas of livelihood, health and care, disaster preparedness and hygiene promotion.
We started the program in middle of June. So now at the moment we are working with 600 families. Out of these 600, 400 families have already received the cash grant. So all these 400 houses are going on. The progress is at different stages. Some people are already in the foundation stage and some others are just there working with the roof.
Our status today, we have really done so very well with a little money that we spend and provide these people. And then, of course, we have strategized that we will do at least a minimum of 2,000 houses, helping almost 5,000 families. This totals up to 25,000 people. This is our initial phase. We believe this could be completed within the course of next year.
The program is carried out in partnership with German Red Cross
and the International Federation of the Red Cross, supported by the Canadian Red Cross, the Norwegian Red Cross, Japanese Red Cross, United Arab Emirates Red Crescent, and South Korean Red Cross, in close coordination with government authorities. In a first step, it will assist up to 5,000 families by means of constructing 2,000 houses, including support to host families and communities. The basis of primary target population for the program is Kilinochchi, Mullithu and Mannar districts, as well as conflict-affected areas of Vavuniya, Trincomalee, Jaffna, Anuradhapura and Pulanarwa districts. Furthermore, it is acknowledged that some of those people displaced intend to return to other areas in Sri Lanka, and therefore these populations too could be considered for support under the program. It is also recognized that some of the returnees were affected by the 2005 tsunami that struck that region and were displaced by it as well as by the conflict. Meanwhile, another project to provide health assistance to returnees who had been displaced by the conflict and the development of inter-ethnic confidence for affected populations in eastern Sri Lanka was also launched by the Red Cross. A three-year project is funded by the European Union with over 2.9 million euros with German Red Cross contributions. The major achievements of the program launched in September 2009 include the reconstruction and rehabilitation of 7 health facilities, mobile health clinics in Trincomalee district, health awareness raising campaigns and promotion of humanitarian values.
Well, it was wonderful to see houses nearing completion. Already 250 are virtually complete, another 400 underway. So on one hand, it was great to see that. But on the other hand, it's so frustrating to think that over 200,000 people are basically homeless and they're living in fairly makeshift shelters. It's 38 degrees and then a few minutes later torrential rain for 4 or 5 hours, so it's not very good conditions to be living in. And I just feel the international community in many respects have let the IDPs down in Sri Lanka, in northern Sri Lanka. The situation is not good.
This is Ramayya Chandrasekaran. He also lives in Vivekananda Nagar. He used to be a baker for over 30 years. He has exceptional skills in icing cakes and making sweets for the people of Kilinochchi. He is a son of a policeman who served the Kilinochchi police in the late 70s. Ramayya's story is quite similar to Arunachalam's story. In fact, most of them has a similar story to tell. His son Subhakar was captured by the LTTE and he managed to escape. However, the LTTE recaptured him and tortured him for making a getaway, and up until today, he is incapable of doing any heavy work due to the injuries sustained.
சரியான கஷ்டம் பிள்ளைகள் பால் மாவுண்டு மாவு கொள்ளை இல்லாது இப்போ இவரும் வெளியில் தெரிஞ்சவங்களுக்கு உள்ளாச்சி தரக்கூடிய வசதி இல்லை. அப்போ இவர்கிட்ட கேட்க இல்லாதான் எங்களுக்கு பால் மாவு வண்டி தாங்க என்னண்டு. அப்போ நாங்கள் இப்படி ஆஸ்பத்திரி போயிட்டு வரோம்னு சொல்லிட்டு போயிருக்கோம். அங்கே ஆஸ்பத்திரியில் இப்படி யாரை போய் ரத்தம் கொடுத்தா பிள்ளைக்கு பால் மாத்திரின்னுன்றது சனம் கதைக்கிறத கேட்டுட்டு போனாங்க. போக அப்படி ஒரு சம்பவம் அங்கே நடக்குது. அப்போ போயிட்டு மருந்தெடுக்கிற மாதிரி போய் இப்படி போய் யாரை போய் ரத்தம் கொடுத்துட்டு பிள்ளைக்கு பால் மாப்பட்டி வண்டி கொண்டு வந்து பிள்ளைக்கு பால் மா கொடுத்தோம்.
Irrespective of their hardships, Ramayya and his son are determined to work their way through in order to find a living. Today they make ice cream together to find a living by selling them for 20 rupees at the Kilinochchi town. In his house, Ramayya does not have electricity, no refrigeration facilities and no high-tech equipment to make ice cream. Daily he makes the amount he can sell, as whatever is left will go to waste during the end of the day. Few months back, Ramayya had to travel to Vavuniya, which is 90 kilometers south of Kilinochchi, in order to bring ice cubes, as there were no refrigeration facilities in Kilinochchi. However, today, due to the development that keeps slowly creeping in, Ramayya manages to get ice cubes from a Kilinochchi town. After the entire box of ice cream set in place, Ramayya makes his way to the nearest town to sell the ice cream for 20 rupees, merely 17 cents in US dollars.
Well, today is a good day. Ramayya manages to sell quite a number of ice cream cones, maybe to the fact that a camera crew is following him and appears to be a star in this city rising from ruins.
ஒரு நிரந்தர ஒரு வாழ்க்கையாக இருக்குது. ஆனால் அந்த வாழ்க்கையில் இலங்கை செஞ்சில் சங்கத்தால் வீடுகள் கட்டி கொடுத்து உடைஞ்ச வீடுகள் எரிஞ்ச வீடுகளை இந்த கிராமத்துக்கு வேதனையாருக்கு செய்து கொடுத்ததுக்கு முதல் நன்றி கண்ணை தெரிவிக்கணும் அவைகளுக்கு. அதே போன்று ஒவ்வொரு ஒரு தொழில் சுய தொழில் செய்கிறவங்களுக்கும் நானும் ஒரு ஐஸ்கிரீம் தொழில் செய்து கொண்டிருக்கேன். அந்த ஐஸ்கிரீம் தொழில் செய்கிறதுக்கு எனக்கு முதல் காணாமல் இருக்கின்றது. ஆகவே அந்த தொழிலை ஊக்குவிப்பதுக்கு அந்த செஞ்சில சங்கத்தால் எதுவும் உதவி செய்து தந்தால் அந்த தொழிலை மீண்டும் பெருப்பிச்சு ஒரு நல்லபடி வாழ்க்கைக்கு கொண்டு வரதுக்கு உதவி செய்யுமாறு இந்த இலங்கை செஞ்சில சங்கம் ரெட் க்ராஸ் பெரியார்களுக்கு இருக்கு.
The Red Cross post-conflict recovery program continues to help thousands and thousands of people just like Ramayya and Arunachala to regain their lives and livelihoods and live in dignity just like everyone else in the island. The owner-driven concept has proven fruitful in these post-conflict situations to rebuild communities, as it gives the beneficiary the sole authority to decide on how their house or their livelihood may come up.
The needs are huge. At this moment, really, there is a gap of 90,000 houses, including the support what we are going, including the commitment from the Indian government. So it's very difficult at this moment, but our ambition and our target is to build up 5,000 houses. So for that, we need the support from the donors to support these people who have been affected with the conflict with for the last 30 years.
Giving a second chance to the most vulnerable people who are battered by an unforgiving war has been no easy task. Currently, the Sri Lanka Red Cross and Red Cross partners in Sri Lanka are pushing the boundaries here at home and abroad to bring in more support and aid to the people like Ramayya and Arunachala and many, many others who were victims of this ruthless war. However, in the positive light, these people too are determined to get up and stay up and make sure that they do their duties as parents in order to give a better life for their children. It is true that the past was gruesome to all of them. It is true that their souls are broken and the light in their eyes are fading away. But their duties as fathers, mothers and elders is not to find a better life for themselves, but to create a better tomorrow for their children so that they will carry the torch of courage and determination to become part of one Sri Lanka.
දුක්ින්ද තමයි ටික දවස් දෙල්ලි ටික ඉඳලා දුක්ින්දලා ගිහිල්ලා දැන් ටිකක් හොඳට ඉන්න දැන් ඉතින්
හරිදන්න බලලා මේ පොඩි පුතා පාඩම් කරනවා දැක්කම ඉන්සල්ලා
ඒ පොඩි පුතා තමයි ඉගෙන ගන්න පාඩම් කරලා එයා ඉගෙන ගන්න වැඩක් කරන්න කියලා ඉන්නවා
එයා ගැන බලු ගොඩක් බලාපොරොත්තු තියෙන
ඔව්
මම කවුරු වෙයි කියලා හිතන්නේ
එයා හොඳට ඉගෙන ගන්න වෙයි හිතනවා.
It's become a forgotten disaster. We've had Haiti, one of the biggest disasters in known memory. We've had Pakistan with over 20 million people affected. The world has moved on and forgotten Sri Lanka. And that's why we have to remind the world out there is that they owe a debt to those people. Those people that suffered for 25, 30 years, we really owe it to them. And it's not all lost. I mean, today I travelled along a really good road. I mean, infrastructure's going ahead, railways, road, electricity, demining. So a lot of positive stuff is happening out there. But it's a humanitarian situation of the people who have suffered for 25 years. They really need our help right now.
Just because the media's not there, don't forget Sri Lanka had a conflict which went to almost 20 years. We will provide you information. If that's the case that you're looking at, we are certain, and our federation can provide you information. Listen to us, not only the media, all because there's something in the media. Don't think that you need to turn around. Look at what is happening in reality. These people are suffering. Come with us to help them.
It's a marvelous and a joyous thing to see that things are slowly coming back to life. The song of the birds can be heard again after a long silence. However, the world seems to have forgotten these children of the war. During the final battle, all eyes were shed on the humanitarian crisis that occurred and on the people who were victims of the event. However, when the cameras left, the lights were dimmed and the world moved on. These people are yet to rebuild their lives in order to really win the war that displaced them.